Hello and welcome to another 2 Minute Tuesday with Sertus. I hope you've all been enjoying the amazing weather lately. I'm Carlson and today our topic is what is smoke control. It's a handy recap on what smoke control is and how it differs from smoke clearance. So, let's start the timer. Smoke control is an important aspect of fire safety that refers to the redirection of hazardous fumes, smoke, and heat in the event of a building fire. A correctly designed smoke control system will keep smoke away from the escape routes of a building and allow occupants to evacuate safely. It will also allow the firefighting service easier ingress into the building. Smoke ventilation systems can be natural or mechanical. They can have a wide range of products within them, such as vents, dampers, fan sets, shafts, smoke curtains, smoke detectors, and many other things. However, it's important to note that smoke control is different to smoke clearance. Smoke clearance uses a notional amount of ventilation to assist firefighting operations, allowing the firefighters to clear smoke from a part of a building, usually after the fire has been extinguished. Smoke clearance is usually required in basement car parks and atria. By definition, smoke clearance offers limited benefit during evacuation and therefore has a simpler design basis. As smoke control systems are designed to control or restrict the movement of smoke around a building to protect an escape route, it's usually necessary to estimate the amount of heat and smoke that a fire will generate, and then we can calculate what ventilation is required. Many buildings are required to have smoke ventilation systems by law. For example, buildings over 11 metres will need smoke control systems. There's a range of guidance, legislation, and regulation that you need to be aware of. However, there are three key documents. That is Approved Document B Fire Safety, BS 991, and BS 9999. Finally, it's important to be aware that smoke control systems play a vital part in the fire safety of a building in tandem with other life safety systems, such as fire alarms, passive fire protection, and sprinkler systems. You'll usually find the information on a building's smoke ventilation requirements in the building specification and fire strategy. That's the end of another 2 Minute Tuesday. I hope these are proving useful. If there's a topic that you'd like to learn more about, put it in the comments below. In the meantime, subscribe to us on YouTube so you don't miss these weekly videos. I'll look forward to seeing you next week, and stay safe.